I'm 19 years old. It has been months since I felt bad.
Okay.
But it's okay, cause I'm rich.
Wait,
psych! I'm still sad as a bitch.
Rapper Juice WRLD is dead after suffering a medical emergency at Chicago's Midway Airport.
The 21-year-old who is named Billboard's best
Juice
new
WRLD
artist this year
is
suffered
dead after suffering a seizure.
On the 8th of December 2019, Jared Anthony Higgins, more commonly known as Juice WRLD, was pronounced dead. But I think that Juice is more than just a legend.
One thing that my mom instilled in me, can't forget to give back no matter what you do. Things I say on purpose for people to look deeper into and maybe to help them realize, you know, something that they didn't realize before about life.
Throughout life, it's always gonna be a lot of discouraging people that, you know, use the word can't and try to hold you back. But you just gotta stay true to yourself and make sure that, you know, you're aware of your potential. And make sure that you know that we all human beings, we all on the same earth. So with that being said, you can achieve anything, if not more than what you see other people achieving.
Jared was born and raised in Chicago, Illinois. His parents split up at an early age, and while he remained in contact with his father, they rarely saw each other. Juice described his mother as a hardcore Christian. She even went as far as to ban rap music from the house while he was growing up, because she thought it could have a bad influence on Jared. This meant that while growing up, he mostly listened to pop and rock music he had heard on video games such as Tony Hawk's Pro Skater. It wasn't until Juice's brother and cousins introduced him to artists such as Chief Keef, Gucci Mane, and Future that he would start gaining unreal interest in rap music. He began creating music in his freshman year of high school, teaching himself to play the piano and guitar.
When if you don't know this, focus. Now I got ADD, now swarming like locusts. Who was this? Making hand signs like he deaf or something. That's okay, I'll be on the beat, spinning fast like crystal meth or something. Really is nothing, making assumptions is nothing. Make you and put you in the oven for no reason or something. I'm the best at it, yes I'm the best at it. I got some bad habits. Then again, I'ma kill people with words, that's mad.
He had older cousins who listened to things that he couldn't listen to. And although I had restrictions on what he could listen to because it wasn't just appropriate for his age, I would find music that I thought he would like because he always kind of leaned toward hip hop, but he also liked rock too. So he was always diverse in his music taste. He liked this screamo music that I just would drive me crazy, but he just loved music. So I think it was always in him.
He began taking music more seriously around 2015. He was 16 at the time. After being told by his friends he was good enough to become a real rapper, he uploaded his first song, Tell Forever, to SoundCloud that same year under the alias Juice the Kid. It was around this time that he and his friends began experimenting with drugs. However, Jared took it a step further than his friends. While Jared's friends were smoking weed, he was taking Percocets and Xanax.
You always had issues with drugs even before you started to get famous and rich?
Yeah, for sure. I mean, it was something that I was into early, low-key, due to music. Cause like, I was a music head, so like in sixth grade, seventh grade, I'm hearing songs about sipping lean. Those are like the real influential years, I feel like, especially for like a boy. Like finding out who your role models are, what you like, basketball, football. That's like when you start kind of choosing the dreams you want to chase, damn near.
Right.
So like, sixth, seventh grade, I was hooping, was playing baseball. I was good at both at the time. But I was also like freestyling and I was really into music. Like I used to damn near worship the shit. Like I was into music so much. So my family putting me on all this different music, Future, Gucci, all these niggas talking about drugs, bro.
You can't help but ignore how fun or how interesting, at least, they're making Zans and Lean and all the shit sound.
Yeah, bro, like, when I heard Future, the first song I ever heard by Future was Ain't No Way Around It. The second song I've ever heard by Future is Dirty Sprite, like off the first Dirty Sprite mixtape.
Mm-hmm.
And that shit, had me wanting to sip lean at like 11, 12 years old, bro.
Yeah.
So, you know, I didn't know if that was what I was really finna be doing, but.
Although Jared's adoration and obsession with music, and in particular artists like Future and Gucci Mane, will play a big role in his success, they also contributed to his everlasting struggles with drugs. But although that's where his desire to experiment with drugs started, it was mostly Xanax that a young Jared would use to chase a high.
I would tell myself to stay as far away from drugs as possible. Make sure to stay grounded with your family. And just don't give up, because a year ago, I was finna quit this shit. Like, I wasn't finna quit this shit, but I was finna stop taking this seriously. Like, it was gonna be like a hobby instead of a passion, you know? Because, I mean, I feel like after a certain point in the artist, whether they want to admit it or not, if they're not seeing results, they're gonna start doubting themselves. And I took that shit to the max.
Jared grew dependent on prescription drugs to deal with his depression and anxiety. His ex-girlfriend was quoted saying, "Even when he had every reason to be happy, he still wasn't. And that's obviously a mental illness." She spoke some more on his relationship with drugs as his career took off, saying that she believed he would take up to 330 milligram Percocet at the time while drinking lean. While drugs can and eventually will ruin your life, it also helped Juice in his creative process, allowing him to feel emotions that his sober mindset couldn't, potentially helping him to create his breakthrough hit, All Girls Are the Same.
Fuck sipping, I'm up down a whole bottle, hard liquor, hard truth, can't swallow, need a bartender.
The music video of All Girls Are the Same was uploaded to the Lyrical Lemonade YouTube channel on the 25th of February 2018 and would change Juice WRLD's life forever. The song came along at the perfect time as Lyrical Lemonade was really starting to take off and becoming the go-to platform for aspiring hip-hop artists. This was the beginning of a long-running creative relationship between Juice and Cole Bennett, which also resulted in a close friendship. While the song certainly brought Juice to the attention of many, getting 500,000 views after the first 2 days, it was a song that was released nearly a year prior that would catapult Juice WRLD into mainstream stardom.
See your shadows in my room. Can't take back the love that I gave you. It's to the point why I love and I hate you, and I cannot change you. So
the song was first released in June 2017 on Juice WRLD's SoundCloud. It started to gain traction after the success of All Girls Are the Same, and will go on to peak at number 2 on the Billboard Hot 100. Just like All Girls Are the Same, the song is about a troubling relationship and produced by the same person, Nick Mira.
When I was making the song, actually the original sample, Sting, Shaped My Heart, I was watching a movie, The Professional, Leon the Professional. It was an outro song, I heard it. I thought it was crazy, I had to flip it into my own beat. That's when I heard it. And then, yeah, it's pretty much where I got the sample from.
When creating the beat, he sampled Sting's Shape of My Heart. And while sounding amazing and contributing to the emo rappers, biggest hit, the use of this sample would turn out to be very costly. Sting describes the song as a beautiful interpretation and is faithful to the song's original form. So faithful, in fact, that Sting would take 85% of the earnings Lucid Dreams made.
I love that version. I mean, that song's been covered easily 50 times, maybe more, but that's probably my favorite.
Okay.
Yeah, I really liked it.
So your version of Shape of My Heart on my songs, what does it sound like?
It's a bit influenced by that, actually.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah, why not? I mean, it sounds modern in that sense. But it's the original song.
Do you remember the first time you heard Lucid Dreams?
Yeah.
Did you hear it on the radio? Or did someone say, Sting, you got to listen to this. Someone's sampling you.
No, they asked for my,
okay,
you know, my blessing.
So they got your, but they, yes, got your blessing.
They got my blessing.
Okay.
You're good with those kinds of, with seeing what people do with,
oh, totally, with your, I'm totally open to hearing what people do with it. That as a basis. You know, it's exciting to hear that. And you know, I'm always surprised and always pleased.
Nick Mira, appearing to be riled up, tweeted about his outrage over this situation. Juice WRLD, however, appeared less fazed. This wasn't the last of the song's legal issues though. In October 2019, broken up pop punk group Yellow Card opened up a lawsuit against Juice WRLD, seeking $15 million in damages and co-ownership of the song, as they believed he stole their melody from the song Hollywood Died. Personally, I do not think their claims are valid. Unfortunately, due to copyright, we can't let you hear the comparison. The pop punk band continued pursuing the lawsuit until the 24th of July 2020, when their lawyer released the following statement. My clients really were uncomfortable about pursuing this action against Juice WRLD's grieving mother as a representative of the estate. As they said previously, they are incredibly sympathetic about the death and were torn initially about pursuing this in light of his death. As a result of all of that's happened, they simply need additional time to decide what they want to do. Because of its big worldwide success, Lucid Dreams went on to become one of the leading singles to his debut album, Goodbye and Good Riddance. Released on the 23rd of May 2018, the album peaked at number 5 on the Billboard Hot 200 and only had one feature, which appeared on the track Wasted with Lil Uzi Vert. Highlights from the album, apart from the obvious two, were Black and White, Candles, I'm Still, and Lean With Me. The album received mixed reviews from critics, but the fans loved it, as the music felt raw, personal, and relatable. On the 28th of May 2021, Anniversary Edition was released with two new songs, 734 and a remix of Lucid Dreams with Lil Uzi Vert.
Year-old XXXTentacion killed in an apparent robbery. Police say the artist, whose real name is Jose Onfroy, was leaving a Broward County motorcycle shop yesterday when he was shot by two men who ran up to his car.
On the 18th of June 2018, XXXTentacion tragically passed away in a botched robbery. And in November prior, another emo rap pioneer, Lil Peep, had sadly passed away due to a drug overdose. Both incidents deeply affected Juice, and he wrote a song as tribute to the deceased artists titled Legends. Legends would eventually go platinum, and Juice wasn't slowing down there. In October that same year, he collaborated with one of his idols, Future, to release the mixtape, WRLD, on Drugs. The mixtape debuted at number 2 behind the soundtrack to A Star Is Born. Juice and Future claimed the whole thing was recorded within a week. Both artists were known in the industry for their ability to relentlessly make song after song, and Juice in particular became renowned for his ability to freestyle.
No problems, I'll give you cancer with this bullet. You can catch this trauma. Man, I know you heard the rumors. Niggas beefing all over computers. Until I catch him lacking in my city. Beat him in his head until he catch a tumor. Tell his mama that I did it. She confused. Why my baby all over the fucking news?
A few months after his initial 1 hour freestyle in the Tim Effort show, Juice went back and did it again, but this time exclusively over Eminem Beats, who was a big inspiration for Juice growing up.
blessed for a second. I'ma shoot him in his ass, I'm reckless. Do it big like football, Texas. I'ma ball out like the Texans. Bitches pay me like taxes. On a mattress, hitting backflips. Ride me carpet, Aladdin. At a space bowling on Saturn. Give a fuck what you say, I don't really care about nothing but the money I manage. Hoes on me, they wanna fuck too, though. Out of space, I've been pulling on Pluto.
Shout to Juice, too, man. Like, yo, that kid was so talented, man. He, like, his freestyle he did on Westwood, where he rapped for an hour, like, what the fuck? And I mean, he was he might have been mixing a little bit of written in there, but the way he was freestyle, like, that's the shit that we used to try to do at the hip-hop shop, was, like, try to work on our freestyles, right? But be able to slip in and out of written when you need to. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? If you got a certain punchline you want to get to take out this dude, right? So, to be so young, he like mastered that so fucking quickly.
Yeah.
It's really sad, man, that like his potential was so off the charts.
Juice would carry on showcasing his special talents on various platforms. And according to Juice, every song on his sophomore album, Dead Race for Love, was freestyled. He recorded the entire album over 3 days. 23 songs over 72 hours. The freestyle element of the album was most noticeable on the track Feeling, where there was a mistake during the song, which he decided to leave in.
I'm in it to me and Tim, y'all. I know I just fucked up, but bitch, I'm still the freestyle king.
The freestyle nature of the project resulted in a variety of sounds, from a dancehall vibe on Hear Me Calling to something close to country on Flaws and Sins. Of course, he stayed true to his familiar emo rap sound throughout the album, in particular his lead single Robbery.
She told me put my heart in the bag, and nobody gets hurt. Now I'm running from her love, I'm not fast.
He had produced yet again another heartbreak hit with the song climbing the charts. At a few live concerts, he changed the lyrics of Robbery as a homage to his girlfriend Ali. Ali Lotti is an Instagram influencer with over 1.7 million followers. She started dating Juice WRLD in late 2018. The two were more or less inseparable, as she would attend recording sessions and join Juice on tour.
A year ago, she DM'd me, not even on no flirting shit, no nothing. She DM'd me like, your music's good, keep it up. And that was pretty much it. Is that good?
Yeah, they're good.
After a while, we were like flirting back and forth a little bit, but even before that, it was on the East Coast. We met in Rhode Island. When we parted ways, I was like, nah, this ain't gonna do it, bro. Like, that's not what's happening. So, I was like, nah, like, man, like, I need you. I couldn't even wait extra day. Imagine a breath of fresh air, but at the same time, somebody to take your breath away. It's not really no feeling like that out there, so no drug ever make me feel like that. No, nobody besides this individual right here.
Later on in 2019, Juice would release yet another hit, Bandit, featuring NBA Youngboy, linking up with Cole Bennett once again for the music video. Everything was starting to come together for Juice. He had found a girl he loved, and his music career was thriving more than ever, collaborating with artists such as Ellie Goulding, Ashley, and BTS. Juice WRLD was a bona fide superstar, helping pioneer a new wave of music. But then, on the morning of December 8, 2019, his life was cut desperately short. 6 days after his 21st birthday, Jared and his friends were traveling to Chicago on a private jet to celebrate. The pilot of the plane had noticed that they were carrying a variety of narcotics and guns, and as a result, alerted law enforcement authorities. Many people think that Jared swallowed several pills of Percocet in an attempt to hide evidence, but recently we learned this wasn't the case. After getting off the plane, he started convulsing, seizing up, and bleeding from the mouth. In an attempt to save his life, he was transported to the nearest hospital, where he was pronounced dead at around 3:15 a.m.
This is by the Atlantic airport. They got a guy seizuring in here.
865 David, an ambulance inside the airport. Where in the airport?
The Atlantic private. Section 6150 Laramie. Individual seizuring.
The autopsy report showed it was due to a toxic level of Percocet and codeine in his system. Fortunately, before his death, Juice was able to collaborate with one of his idols, Eminem, for the track Godzilla. You get away, I'ma feed you to the monster. I'm normal during the day, but at night turn to a monster. When the moon shines like ice road truckers, I look like a villain out of those blockbusters. This was his first posthumous appearance, and the song actually reached the number one spot in the UK. The music video was directed by Cole Bennett, who was able to pay tribute to Juice by creating one of the standout music videos of the year. Since then, there have been a number of other posthumous features from Juice, such as PTSD, Blast Off, No Me and Me, and most recently, Can't Leave You Alone. In a strip club, trying to get all the pretty girls to dance. On the 24th of April, 2020, the song titled Righteous was released. Juice's mom released the song along with the announcement that she'd be starting the Live Free 999 fund. On July 10, 2020, Create A Productions released the first full posthumous Juice album titled Legends Never Die. The record debuted number 1 on the Billboard Hot 200. Juice WRLD's album now ranks as the biggest posthumous debut since Biggie Smalls' Life After Death. The biggest songs on the album were Smile, Righteous, Wishing Well, and Come and Go. Especially Wishing Well hits fans hard. Something feels broke, need to fix it. I cry out for help, do they listen? I'ma be alone until it's finished. Juice's manager Lil Bibby once said they found more than 2,000 unreleased Juice songs.
How many songs do you have of his?
Like 3,000.
Wait. You have 3,000 songs?
Or more. I'll be finding more songs.
One of the saddest things looking back on the death of Juice WRLD is the sense of inevitability. Of course, there's the obvious theme of his drug problem throughout his discography, but there's something in particular that feels more haunting. Weeks before his death, a prank started to become a trend on TikTok, where Juice's hit song, Lucid Dreams, would play, and at a certain point in the music, it would sound like a broken record, replaying the same fraction of a second repeatedly. When it got to this point in this song, whoever is doing the challenge would pretend to have a seizure. And maybe the most famous coincidence, on his tribute track to XMPeep, Legends, he sang the following. What's the 27's club? We ain't making it past 21. Just a week after turning 21, Juice died. And to top it all off, he died the same day as John Lennon, who he mentioned on his track All Girls Are the Same. Don't get me wrong, I don't believe in any conspiracy theories, and I'm sure it's all just coincidence, but it just emphasizes this feeling that this tragedy was inevitable. So how big is Juice WRLD's legacy? Even after his death in 2019, Juice became the most streamed artist on Spotify in the US in 2020. And with his album Legends Never Die, Juice WRLD has become the third artist in US chart history to have 5 songs from one album in the top 10 of the Billboard Hot 100 at the same time, an achievement only matched by the Beatles and Drake. After his death, it has become abundantly clear that we have truly lost a legend and that we need to help young people in their battles with addiction, anxiety, and depression.
Anyway, yeah, no cliche shit. You can do whatever the fuck you put your mind to. Whatever the fuck you put your mind to. It don't matter what it is. Like, everybody you see, your favorite rapper, whether it be me or whoever the fuck else you admire, for whatever reason, they're human just like you. So, with that being said, they bleed just like you, they breathe just like you, they eat just like you. The only thing changing y'all, obviously, is like, you know, they known around the world and you not known yet. But I say yet to say that you could do whatever the fuck you put your mind to. You can be like, you could be in the same position as your favorite rapper. Or you could be better than them. Like, you could be whatever the fuck you want to be. Like, you have the power to do whatever the fuck you want to do. You just got to give it your all, have faith, and do it. And I'm living proof of that. Your favorite rapper is living proof of that. Yeah. So, you can do whatever the fuck you want to do in this life. Remember that. And I know it sounds cliche, but that's some real shit. And I can't tell you that enough, because I accomplished that. Now I need some surgery. I'm falling apart. It's like I'm lost in emotions. Use this song as a rope to wrap around the commotion. Silence.